This video is going to be about finding the domain and range of functions. And specifically, what I want to deal with is finding the domain and range when you've been given a function in the form of either a table of values or a graph. So let's look at a table first. I've created this table of values. I have two columns. The left column, where the input goes, is labeled x, and the output column I've labeled f of x, since it's a function. I could have labeled it y, but I've used f of x. And what I see is this. When my input is negative 2, the output is 4. When the input is negative 1, the output is 8. When the input is 0, the output is 12. And when the input is 1, the output is 16. And let's say I've been told to find the domain of this function. Now, domain is basically the values that you can have as input values for a function. So looking at this, the input column is my left column, and the only thing I know about the input is that possible inputs are negative 2, negative 1, 0, and 1. In other words, the numbers in the left column, in the input column. So the domain for this function is just going to be a set of numbers. It's going to be the set of the numbers negative 2, negative 1, 0, and 1, the numbers that I have as input. If I have to find the range basically is the values that I can have as output. Well, the only values I know about for this function are 4, 8, 12, and 16. So my range is also going to be a set of numbers. It's going to be 4, 8, 12, and 16. Okay, so range is all of the input values. I'm sorry, domain is all of the input values. Range is all of the output values. Now, one thing to realize, I've been given this table of values in a regular table form, but I could have taken these pairs of values, the negative 2 and 4 and the negative 1 and 8, and I could have been given them as a set of ordered pairs. In other words, I could have had the ordered pair negative 2 comma 4, and then the ordered pair negative 1 comma 8, and then 0 comma 12, and 1 comma 16. And if I were given those values in terms of ordered pairs, and I were told to find the domain and range, I would just look at the first value in each of the ordered pairs. So the negative 2, the negative 1, the 0, and the 1. Those are my input values. And the domain would be those numbers, the set of those numbers. For the range, I'd look at the second value in each of the ordered pairs. And all of those second values would be my range. Okay, so that's it for tables of values. Let's go on and look at graphs. I've drawn a coordinate plane here. I've got an x-axis and a y-axis. And I've drawn in the graphs of three different functions. One I've drawn in blue, one's in red, and one's in green. And as you can see, they are very, very different functions. But the point I want to make is this. If I'm told to find the domain of these functions, what I'm going to see is they all have exactly the same domain. The domain is, remember, the input that a function can have. And if I'm given a graph, the input is that the graph can have, or that the function can have, is any place on the horizontal axis, which is the input axis, that will allow me to find what the output would be. So if I start at negative 3, I find that I can find an output. I can find a vertical axis value, or in this case, a y value, for each of my graphs. I can do that at negative 2. I can do it at negative 1. I can do it at 0. I can do it at 1. Even though at 1, my graph, my red graph jumps around, I still know that at 1, I've got an output which is over here, at 1 on the y-axis, and then at 2, I've got an output, and in between, I'm in a totally different place. I've made a jump, but I haven't lost the ability to use any of the numbers between 1 and 2 to find an output. And then I can keep going on with all three graphs until I get to 4, and at 4, my input stops. I can't find any input. I can't use any input after 4, because after that, there's no more place on the graph for me to find what the output is. Okay? So if you think about this, I don't really care what the output is. I just want to make sure that I would be able to find it. So I can take all of the values on my vertical axis where the output is and get rid of them. I don't care what they are. I just want to know that I could find the output if I had to. So my input then for this graph, if I'm told to write it, let's say in, my domain for this graph, if I'm told to write it in interval notation, the domain would be the interval. I'll start with a closed bracket because I'm beginning at -3 and including -3. And then it goes all the way up to 4. And it includes 4, so once again, I'll have a closed bracket. The fact that the red graph jumps, that it's not totally continuous, doesn't really matter. All that matters is I can give an input on any of those graphs from any number from -3 up to and including 4. Okay? Let's take a look at range. Well, range is just the inverse of domain. In other words, looking at this graph, I've got once again a coordinate plane. I've got an x-axis and a y-axis, and I've got three different graphs, very different, and I'm looking for the range of each of the graphs. Well, each of the graphs has a range. In other words, the y values that the graph has, the output values, it has a range that begins down at -3 and goes up to and includes 2. The blue graph goes up to 2 and then turns around again, but it doesn't matter. Its highest point, its highest output value or vertical axis value is y. So the range for this is going to be the interval beginning down at -3 on this vertical axis, -3. And since it begins there, I'll use a square bracket, and it goes all the way up to 2 with a square bracket. I don't care what the values are on my horizontal axis. All I care about is knowing what outputs the graph gave. And all of these graphs give outputs, give dependent variable values, if you want, that go from -3 up to and including 2. Okay? So that's about it. You should be fine with these. Do a little bit of practice to make sure you're comfortable with them and don't get confused. Okay? But domain and range is not that hard a thing to deal with. Okay, take care. I'll see you next time.